Proton VPN keeps things rather simple, but even I got a little lost on the first go through. No worries though, since then I have figured out this VPN and I am here to show you how to use Proton VPN every step of the way to its full potential. All right, to start this Proton VPN tutorial, first, let's register and download the app straight from their website. So to register and download the app, click on Create Account on their website and then select Get Proton Free right here. Now, it's going to ask you if you want to go with VPN Plus, but even if you do, click Continue with Free as you probably want the Plus plan with the discount to get the best price. Oh, look, what a coincidence. I have a discount code in the description. Anyhow, let's start with the free version, and later you can upgrade with my discount if you like. After creating your account and downloading the app, let's open it up. I've got to say, I actually really like the design choices for their user interface, but other than that, it's pretty much what you would expect from any other best free VPN. No bandwidth limits, no ads, and not that many locations and way fewer servers compared to the premium version. Proton VPN free app allows you to connect to 5 countries, but you can choose which one. Once you click this connect button, it automatically connects you to the fastest option depending on where you are. The free version also comes with a Proton VPN extension, but that's pretty much all there is. There are no additional features like an ad blocker. Torrenting's also not an option until you upgrade. So it's about time we get Proton VPN Plus. To do that, use the link from the description or scan this QR code. It will apply my discount and get you the lowest price. You're welcome. There you'll have to select the subscription length. Other than that, there's no difference in features or what you get. Just keep in mind that the longer the commitment you make, the cheaper it is over time. After getting the subscription, reopen the app. Notice how the server pool is much, much bigger now. I can choose any location I want to connect to by using the list or the map interface. At the moment, there are over 11,000 servers in 117 countries. These numbers are among the highest in the VPN industry. Next to servers, you can also see a bunch of symbols. This triangle, or a play button, marks servers optimized for streaming, ensuring that I can access all my favorite platforms. The globe icon is for smart routing servers that provide country-specific IPs while being physically elsewhere. Now, when you're planning to torrent, select a server with a double-sided arrow like this one. Those are P2P optimized servers for secure and efficient torrenting. The onion symbol is what you expect. This is servers that route your connection through the Tor network, while secure core servers, marked with a lock, route traffic through multiple locations. Both of these increase your anonymity online, but at the cost of performance. The difference is that secure core servers are owned by Proton, located in Switzerland. Lastly, the wrench symbol just means that the server is under maintenance. All right, now you know which servers are for what. Let's make sure your VPN is actually doing its job and VPNing. Just pull up ipleak.net and check what IP address and location it shows. Now, connect to any VPN server and refresh the page. If nothing changes, well, you've got a leaky situation, and that's not good. But no stress, because in my experience, Proton VPN is built like a digital fortress. No leaks, no worries. Okay, but besides these specialty servers and standard VPN protection with Proton VPN Premium, there are also many more features to explore. First, let's talk about the MVP of VPN security, the kill switch. When it's on, it instantly cuts off your internet if the VPN connection drops, making sure your IP address doesn't slip through if your VPN connection drops. If it's off, well, I recommend that it's not. You'll find this feature in the settings menu. Luckily, it's on by default, but just in case, just double check that it's really on and then just let it do its thing. Right up there with the kill switch is DNS leak protection, which makes sure your DNS request goes through the VPN instead of your ISP. Yeah, all right, it might slow things down a teeny tiny bit, but I'd rather take a slight hit to speed than let my ISP or data vultures peek into my browsing habits. Same deal with IPv6 support. Proton VPN keeps all IPv6 traffic locked down, so there are no sneaky leaks. Both of these are enabled by default, so unless you're feeling chaotic, just don't mess with them. If you're sick of ads, sketchy phishing sites, and all that internet garbage, do yourself a little favor and turn on NetShield. You can find it right here next to the secure core servers. This built-in ad blocker doesn't just clean up your browsing experience, it also actively shuts down online threats before they can touch you. Plus, having this baked into my VPN means I don't need to bother with a separate ad blocker. You know that soul-crushing moment when you're deep into a show and it suddenly starts buffering? Yeah, not a great feeling, is it? Luckily, Proton VPN's got our backs with VPN Accelerator. Say you're streaming from a server in the UK while chilling in the States. Long distance can mess with your speeds, making things laggy or blurry. That's what VPN Accelerator is for. Just turn it on and you'll get smoother, faster streaming. Now, if you're into torrenting, Proton VPN port forwarding is your best friend. It lets you open a port in your torrenting app, making it easier to share files. A lot of VPNs don't even bother with this. Just head to settings, jump into the advanced tab, and you'll see port forwarding right there on top. One thing to note though is that this only works on special Proton VPN servers marked with a double arrow icon, like the ones I showed you at the beginning of this Proton VPN tutorial. All right, so one of my favoritest things about Proton VPN has to be the profiles feature. It lets me create a preset set of settings for different users. To create one, head to the profiles tab, tap create profile. From there, choose the type of connection you want. Standard, secure, core, P2P, or Tor. Then give it a name and pick a color to keep things organized. Then set up your connection preferences. Once everything looks good, just tap save. And the convenient thing about this is you can create multiple profiles and switch between setups with a single click. To use connection profiles, just go to the profiles tab and choose the one you want. Proton VPN will instantly connect using the settings you save. If you ever need to manage your profiles, just go to profiles and manage profiles. So that covers the Proton VPN side of things, but Proton can offer more than that. That's if you're willing to pay a little bit extra to get Proton Unlimited, which includes all of Proton's products. Besides the VPN, you also get Proton Calendar, which ensures your schedules remain confidential, protecting your personal events from prying eyes. Meanwhile, Proton Drive gives you full control over your files with secure cloud storage. There's also Proton Pass, a password manager that protects your logins and online identity. Proton Wallet lets you store and transact Bitcoin privately with a secure self-custody wallet. And lastly, Proton Mail, which is an encrypted email provider that keeps your conversations private by default. If you want to see how good that is, I have a video comparing Gmail to Proton Mail. Okay, that covers this tutorial on how to use Proton VPN. But if you have any questions, as always, just drop them in the comments section. And if you still don't have Proton VPN, you can get it at the best price available with the discount code that I have left in the description for you. Anyway, I'll see you guys around.